outstanding, amazing, astonishing, swag is the words to describe this Halo 3 ODST port on the Xbox One. And that's obviously what I want to talk to you guys about in this video, is what I think of this, a wee bit of discussion, not so much a review, because I'm not really qualified to do that, I don't really have the experience to really judge a game like that. But I just want to give you guys a wee bit of a discussion video on this Halo 3 ODST port on the Xbox One. And I say port, not a remaster, because it's not a complete remaster like Halo 2 Anniversary was. It's not completely done from scratch. It's just a wee bit of an upgrade, so that means enhanced textures, sound, lighting, shadows, all that sort of stuff. And obviously the 1080p, 60 frames per second is no joke as well. This is the way Halo should be played, fellas. Oh my god, fellas. I can't even explain it. It just runs so smoothly, and it's definitely a superior way to play. Because I can't go back to playing on the 360 after this. The 1080p, 68 frames per second. Oh my goodness. It's just awesome. Love it. Love it so much. And that's obviously what I want to discuss with you guys in this video. Not obviously just the 1080p, 60 frames per second, but Halo 3 ODST and my opinions. And have a wee bit of discussion with you guys in this video. Sorry, let's get straight to it, fellas. This game has an incredible story, incredible characters, amazing areas, amazing scenes, and amazing characters to really get you invested in the story. And that's pretty much all positives, fellas. I can't really say anything bad about this game because it runs smoothly. Even the controls, after like how many years, fellas? 5 or 6 years since this game came out. Whew. Where has the time gone, fellas? Holy shit, am I getting old? 17 years old, and all that life experience, eh, fellas? All that life experience at 17. But man, where has the last 5, 6, 7 years gone, fellas? Oh my goodness, it's gone so fast. But this game has aged incredibly well, as I mentioned before. It just plays smoothly, it goes smoothly, the controls feel fluid, and the game flows. Like all the missions and all the levels, areas, they just flow together. And there's never any times in the game where you feel like, ugh, I can't be bothered doing this, because every single area you explore has its own distinctive feel. For example, the main character you play as is the rookie, and it's usually him at night. And at night, when you're exploring this like big city of New Mombasa, it's very kind of eerie and quiet, and there's a really cool music that plays in the background. It's a really kind of slow paced stealth kind of game. But during the day, which is obviously the gameplay you guys can see in the background, and you're playing as other members of his squad like 24 hours earlier during the daytime, it's all action packed, all hardcore, head punching, vehicles, explosions, death, and people suffering, all that sort of good shit that happens during the day. But at night, it's more of a slow paced stealth kind of game, and it keeps changing back and forth, and that just adds to the dynamic of this game. And I love it, fellas. I'm really enjoying this. And it's pretty much the same experience as I had 5, 6 years ago, except on the Xbox One, with obviously enhanced textures and lighting, sound, and all that sort of good stuff, which I enjoy, man. This game's so much fun, fellas. If you guys are a fan of Halo, trust me, go out and purchase this. It's only an 8GB download. If you got Master Chief Collection on day one, you guys are going to get it for free, along with the Relic map and Halo 2 Anniversary as well for the multiplayer. But don't be too worried, fellas. If you guys didn't play Master Chief Collection on day one, you can still get this. It's about $10, I think, just over $10. I can't see the exact price because I obviously got it for free. So if I go onto the store, it just says I've already downloaded it, so I can't see the price. So I can't really check that for you guys, but it'll be around $10, I think. Correct me if I'm wrong, fellas. It's about $4.99 American, so I'm imagining about $10 New Zealand money. But there we go, fellas. That's kind of all I wanted to discuss with you guys in this video, just my brief opinions on Halo 3 ODST port on the Xbox One. And it's amazing, fellas. I love it. Can't wait to get back playing it and get some videos up for you guys. I've got some cool Easter eggs planned, some cool discussion videos, and some content for you guys in mind. But anyway, fellas, I just want to quickly mention, this is the third time that I've tried to upload this video today, so if this uploads, it'll be sick. And as you see me beast this Wraith, man, the Wraith stands no chance against Zombie Bang the Great. So as always, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you all for watching. It is greatly appreciated, as always. Be sure to like me on Facebook, Zombie Bang Gaming, to keep up to date with Zombie Bang swagness. See you, fellas, on the next one.